transformer with 1,000 primary turns, so on this primary side, it has 1,000 turns. Secondary side has 200 turns. Input voltage, incoming voltage, was given as 400. And input current was 2 amperes. We want to know what is the output voltage, secondary voltage, and output current, secondary current. Using the law of voltage, Vs over Vp, and S over Np. Primary voltage is 400, and S is 200, and P is 1,000. Output is unknown. So the one over five. Cross multiply 5x times 400. Divide both sides by 5. Now we can solve for current, which is IP over IS. Incoming current was given as 2. Output current is unknown. RNS to NP is 1 to 5. Cross multiply. 2 times 5 is 10. 10 amps. So output is 80 volt at 10 current. 10 amps. With this, the amount of power given will be the same as output. Input power with the same as output power, due to the fact that the output side where the current has fluctuates to compensate for changes in that. So input power will be the same as output power. This can't make energy anywhere. So power will remain constant, whether it's input or output. And we could prove this by figuring out what input power is. And the equation for power is, remember what it is?
Current times volts.
P equal IV.
Or current squared time.
Since we don't know what's resistance, this we'll be using this, right? So let's say input power would be I equal V, which means the power current, input current, and voltage is 400, which means power is
800.
mass, right? Outward side, current is 10, voltage is 8, which is 2, 800. So input and output is the same. We're going to talk about different types of components we've got over here. I'm going to start from the least efficient to the most efficient. Least efficient to most efficient. The most simplest type of transformer is an open core. I mean, there's another one called the air core, but they don't mean that. So an open core is the simplest type of transformer. Constructed. It is designed with each side have a coil. And each side has a core. The benefit of constructing an open coil transformer is that it is cheap to build. The downside with an open core is that it's inefficient in terms of generating, producing electricity without losing power. So it has what's called leakage flux. So the downside of having an open core is that there's leakage flux, meaning that it loses some of its power as it produces power and electricity. So an open core is like this. So one set of core primary has a and the other side has and within that slide. Nothing attaching to it. So electricity goes through it. And apply the magnetic field and then produces electricity. So that's an open core. A closed core. It's like a donut shape construction. So one side has this, and the other side has this. The core is laminated through its surface process to prevent leakage flux. So it's more efficient than the open core. The downside is it's more expensive to build. It provides a continued path to which the magnetic flux radiate out toward to it and interacting with the secondary side. So it's more efficient compared to the open core. But it costs more to build. Yes?
Are there rods in that one?
Well, the shape would be like the rod. Okay.
So it goes around
yeah.
The donut?
And then we have what's called a shell core. It's pretty much two closed core attached to another. And primary and secondary side attached at the center. This is the most sophisticated, most advanced type of shell core. So it's the most expensive to construct. The windings are also insulated to prevent for the leakage flux. With shell core, this is a type of core transformer that's built in today's modern X-ray imaging system. That's the three basic type of transformer instructions. Open, so-called close, and shell. Any questions? That's it. Yay. The sun's still up, I think.